Hi everybody, I'm Jeremy Krug and welcome to my chemistry channel. The College Board has come out with some pretty big news for AP Chemistry with regard to the 2023 exam. But before we start, if you're new here, I hope you subscribe because by doing so you'll have instant access to my full AP Chemistry course on YouTube. So just click on playlists and you'll find everything you need. Now for the big news. Calculators will now be allowed on the multiple choice section of the AP Chemistry exam starting in the spring of 2023. Now this is huge news for both students and teachers, and I think this is a very good move. Just so you know, calculators used to be allowed on multiple choice up until the mid-90s. So it's basically taken College Board over 25 years to reverse course on this one and go back to letting students use calculators on multiple choice again. Personally, I think this should have happened a long time ago. The multiple choice section is worth half of a student's score, and this is the section where a big chunk of the questions are conceptual and involve scientific reasoning using the principles of chemistry. But the problem has been, while a lot of the multiple choice questions are conceptual, not all of them are. And on some of these computational problems, they require students to do some fairly sophisticated math, such as square scientific notation numbers, or take a square root, or do long division, all without a calculator. Now, high school students, especially AP students, are able to do that, but let's be honest, in the classroom on a daily basis, they use a calculator. And to be even more honest, practicing chemists who actually solve these problems on a daily basis have access to a calculator as well. So it's completely reasonable to allow AP students to use a calculator on these multiple choice questions. Of course, it's never been an issue on the free response section. Students have pretty much always been allowed to use a calculator on free response. So for full disclosure, I don't work for College Board. I'm just an AP Chemistry teacher who's been doing this for a long time. But in my mind, not allowing students to use a calculator on a test like this causes an issue with the validity of some of the questions. Now, how valid an assessment is, or how valid a question is, refers to how well a test or a question measures what we say it's measuring. So to illustrate this in an extreme example, let's say that a teacher writes a test for an AP Chemistry class, but the test is written in some other language that the students don't understand. Let's just say the Mayan language. So the students take the test, they fail the test, but not because they didn't know the content. The test was not valid because the test was measuring not just chemistry knowledge, but it was also measuring how well students understood the Mayan language. So the validity of a test question becomes an issue when the question isn't just testing the subject area of the test, but some other skill that's not really a standard of that test. So let's take this problem right here. It's a typical question that a student would be expected to answer on the AP Chem exam. It says, after a certain chemical is applied to plants, its decomposition is a first-order reaction with a half-life of 39 days. What is the rate constant, K, for the decomposition reaction? So in this problem, you're expected to use this equation, half-life equals 0.693 divided by K. So you'd rearrange the problem and essentially have to divide 0.693 by 39 days. With a calculator, this would take all of about 5 seconds, but without a calculator, you have to solve this by hand. And looking at the four choices, a good estimator could eliminate choices C and D without doing any calculation, but you really still have to do long division to get the correct answer of the A or the B. So this question is not just testing chemistry, it's also testing how good you are at long division, which last time I checked is not an AP Chemistry standard. So not a completely valid question to ask without a calculator. And here's another one. The concentration of fluoride aqueous that is desired in a drinking water mixture is 4.0 times 10 to the negative fifth molar. Based on the information above, the maximum amount of strontium 2 plus ions that can be present in the mixture without lowering the concentration of fluoride below the desired level is closest to which of the four choices? So to solve this problem, you have to write the equilibrium constant expression for the reaction. And if you don't understand what that is yet, that's okay. You'll learn that in this course and then plug in the numbers from the problem. However, at this point, once you get to this spot here, you have to know how to square a number written in scientific notation. It's not hard, but it is tricky for a lot of students, especially if it's done by hand. And to be completely honest, most high school students use their calculator for this. Now, once again, you can eliminate two of the choices just by being a good estimator, but one of the choices seems to be written specifically to throw off the student who has trouble squaring a number and dividing by hand. So once again, having access to a calculator improves your chance of success on this question by quite a bit. So what does this change imply for the future of the AP Chemistry exam, which is probably what you want to know as a student or as a teacher? Well, once again, I'm no expert, but my prediction is that College Board will continue to ask mostly conceptual questions on the multiple choice section, but you can expect to see the computational intensity turned up a little bit on the questions that require math. And since you are allowed to use a calculator, you're going to be expected to use a calculator, and I expect that any questions requiring computation will be much more difficult to do without a calculator starting in 2023. Well, I hope you enjoyed my video. Hope you learned something here, and if you get a chance, hope you check out my complete AP Chemistry course right here on my YouTube channel, and subscribe so you'll have every bit of AP Chemistry content at your fingertips. Once again, I'm Jeremy Krug. Thanks for watching. I hope to see you again so we can learn some more chemistry together.